to use service principle for connecting to data source. So we are using common service data source as a trigger, and we will use a service principle to have its connection established. So if you check here, we can have our own user connection, or when we add a new connection, it gives us an option to connect via service principle. So what service principle does is, rather than connecting from your account, it connects to an application interface. And what it helps is it takes away the dependency from a user to the application. So in case the user gets fired or user is not in the in an organization anymore, this connection still lives on because we have established an application of that. So what we do is we register an app in Azure, and we put the credential, client ID, client secret, and tenant over here. And also we have a non-interactive user setup in our Power Apps environment and give it the appropriate role. Let's go to portal.azure.com for all the credentials and stuff. Go to Azure Active Directory, and then from your left navigation, you can register an app by clicking at app registration. So now you can register an app and call this probably a demo. So I'm just creating a demo registration, so I'll call it demo regs. So you have an option to define who can have this application, if it's a single tenant or for personal Microsoft account only. So we'll just have this for the organizational directory only. I click register. Once this is done, so this is our client ID, this is the tenant ID, and now I need to give API permission for this application, so I'll go to API permission, and so this app needs to have permission to access the information from the Dynamics, so I'll click on API permission and then add a permission. So to have the ability to get data from the common data service or Dataverse, we will use Dynamics CRM, which it should have been CDS here, which you can get from APIs my organization uses, but you can just have this one, which also means the same. So when I click this, it gives me an option to impersonate the user. So I click this, I'll add a permission, and after this I'll go to client certificates and I'll create a secret client secret. So you can also use this service principle to access the data of Dataverse using web APIs. Once this is done, go to your Power Apps, and when you click on Advanced Settings, you will have this page open, and from here you can go to Security, and then you can create an application user. Go to Users, click on. So you can switch this view to application users. You can create a new application user and put the object ID of this app that we have registered. So I'll create a new application ID, application user. So this is a non-interactive user. It's not a real person, but it will be connected with this app and will access the data through this app. So switch the view from user to application user. And when you do that, you have an option to place the application ID, which you can copy from here and then place it over here. Save. So once you save this, it creates a non-reactive user for you. So I'll copy this ID and come back to my flow, put it over here, and I can call it maybe service principal. And then client secret is something which is over here. So I can copy this, put it here. And for the tenant, I go to overview, copy from here and paste it here. And I can click create. And then you can add other step of the flow below. And apart from that, we need to define a security role for this user. So that based off that security rule, it will access data. So you can go to manage roles and then assign whatever security rules that is available. So in this way, you can use service principle for flows. What I've observed is using service principle, the triggers happens quite fast, the performance has increased tremendously. So try it out and feel the difference. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and click on the bell notification to stay updated with all the informations. Thank you so much.